Shalom. I want to give all praise and glory unto Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai, Ba'ashem, Ha, Rekah, Kodash. Double honors goes out to the elder apostles of Great Millstone for teaching me this truth. Also, I want to acknowledge all the Akiyam who are pushing this truth with sincerity throughout the four corners of the earth. All right. All right, so the Spirit today has me in, let me see, Psalm 36, and I'm going to start at the top, all right? So let's get it. Psalm 36 and 1, it says, "The transgression of the wicked saith within my heart that there is no fear of Yahweh before his eyes." Because it's the wicked, Esau-Edom, that's what he believes. He don't believe in Yahweh, right? He doesn't believe in Yahweh. That's what makes him, like Apostle Tahar said the other day on your camp, a goddamn fool. He doesn't believe in the Most High, right? That's what a fool is, a non-believer. Psalm 18 and 1. Actually, you know what? Let me go to Romans. Let's see. Let's get Romans 3 and 18. It says, "There is no fear of Yahweh before their eyes." All right? Talking about the wicked, right? Paul's letter to the Romans, that was the Israelites in Rome. So that's what he just said, right? Psalms 3. Let me get that. I'm sorry. Romans 3 and 18. Let me get it again. "There is no fear of Yahweh, the power before their eyes." That's how these Edomites feel. They don't fear Yahweh. Matter of fact, Yahweh's going to put the spirit on them to have war, to make war with the angels. All right, like it tells you in Revelation. So in Psalms 36 and verse 2. "For he flattereth himself in his own eyes until his iniquity be found to be hateful." All right, and that's the spirit of these Edomites. Look at Donald Trump, how he would always flatter himself in his speeches. You know, and now you have Creepy Joe. You know, he's acting as if he's concerned for the people, you know, really, really pushing the hokey pokey jab on everybody, right? That's the center of all his speeches is, on that hokey pokey, you know. So anyway, he flattereth himself in his own eyes until his iniquity be found to be hateful. See? And really, that is a hateful thing for him to put that hokey pokey in you. You know, put that to jab you up. That's a hateful thing, especially with the everything that comes behind that, you know. Just, You see a bunch of people on the internet exposing, you know, how they've had lost family members, people that have had strokes, healthy young people, you know what I'm talking about, and all kinds of different things that have came about because they took the hokey pokey, all right? And you know we always have to use code words because Esau-Edom, he'll remove the video, you know? You use certain words. So let's see. Psalms 36 and 3. "The words of his mouth are iniquity and deceit. He hath left off to be wise and to do good." See, so he's put that away from him. Esau-Edom, he walked away from being good, you know. And that's the spirit the Most High put on him. To be the wicked, to be the left-hand side, to be sinister, all right? You know, when you think of the word sinister, it's talking about, you know, wickedness, you know, bad things, you know. A left-hand side, then I believe the word sinistro is means the left hand, I mean the left side. See? So that's what Esau Edom is. He hath left off to be wise and to do good. He doesn't give wisdom, you know? He doesn't teach people wisdom. Oh, instead he's iniquity and deceit. You see? And you know, the virus, you know, we're coming into it. Yeah, it's a real virus. It's something that, you know, we believe is man-made, created in a laboratory by Esau Edom. And then they, you know, used, Wuhan, China, as a scapegoat, you know, where it started. But ultimately, you know, it's all Psalms 83. They're confederate against thee. All right. The nations, the heathen nations are confederate against thee. That's what you read in Psalms 83. I'm not going to go to it. But just letting you know, these other nations, they're together against the Israelites. The ones they're calling blacks, Latinos, Native Americans right now, who are actually Israelites. See? So, he's out there deceiving 2/3 of our people. Verse 4, he deviseth mischief upon his bed. He setteth himself in a way that is not good. He abhorreth not evil. So he doesn't hate evil, and evil goes into bad times. He doesn't hate bad times. Matter of fact, the Lord puts the spirit on him, Esau Edom, the so-called white man, to oppress the Israelites and put us in bad times. You know, like the example is this pandemic, you know. They're using it to oppress you. They're using it to control you. You know, he devised this thing up. You know, he's clever too, because if when you watch the news, you know, if you're not part of this elect, it's easy to deceive you, you know. And you can see how it is. We're not deceived because, you know, we're the hopeful elect. Let's see. Matthew 24, I believe, yeah. Matthew 24, let's get it. Because Esau Edom is crafty when he, you know, goes in his, using his power of deception. You right? You see? Let's see, let me go Matthew 24:24. Let's get it. For there shall arise false Hamashiachs and false prophets, and shall show great signs and wonders, and so much that if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect. See, so if it was possible, this devil is so crafty, you know, he would deceive us as well. But see, we're not ignorant to Satan's devices. That's in Corinthians. Let me get that. Corinthians. 2 Corinthians 2:11. Let me get it. 2 Corinthians 2:11. Lest Satan should get advantage of us, for we are not ignorant of his devices. See? So the elect are not going to be ignorant, and they're not going to be deceived. We're not ignorant of the devices, you know. His hokey pokey is a device against us. His CHIP is a device against us. See, and we have wisdom. Remember, we read early that the wicked, they put off wisdom. See, he hath left off to be wise and to do good. That's what we read in Psalm 36. But he's crafty, and what being, you know, the hopeful elect, you watch the news and you can see how crafty he is, you know. And then one of the craftiest is that little devil, Dr. Fauci. Because he's, you know what I mean, he's going in on the deception. He's a heavy dose of deception, that dude, you know. I mean, they're talking about how quickly the spreading of the Omicron, and it's just, it's way, it's going to pass the Delta variant and the COVID-19. I mean, this devil, he's so deceptive, man. He's bringing up, he's telling you all these different viruses and he's pinpointing them. And he's deceiving you and making it sound like each new variant is more deadly and more contagious than the last, you know. And he's got his whole agenda and he's got all these people, you know, who are in on this in the media. You know, the media is controlled. So they there's only so much they can report. You know, there's certain things they don't report that they should, you see. So let's go back to Psalms 36. And I'm at verse 5. You see, this devil, he doesn't hate evil. He don't hate bad times. You know, he's going to put you Israelites through hell, especially you two-thirds. And that's coming, man. He's getting ready to lock these cities down again. You know, there's going to be a lack of food pretty soon. You're going to have famines. You know, people are going to start losing it, man. And you can just see it all playing out with the state of Babylon America, the way it is right now. You can see all these things play out. You know, you can see neighbors getting robbed by their neighbors because one guy was able to go inside the store and get groceries while another guy was not able to go in. Because why? Because he didn't get microchipped, or he didn't get the jab. You know, they're gonna bring on these draconian laws, man. The draconian laws are, you know, that means severe laws, and that's this devil, man. He's deceiving you all the way to the bank, man. And two-thirds of our own people are gonna fall for his deception. Because it says, we read in Matthew 24:24, that he's so crafty and deceiving that he could, if it was possible, he would deceive the elect. But see, it's not possible to deceive the elect. Because why? Because we're not ignorant to Satan's devices. So let me go back to where we are in 36 Psalm, the 36th Psalm. It reads in verse 6, or Salakia 5. Thy mercy, O Yahweh, is in the heavens, and thy faithfulness reacheth unto the clouds. Thy righteousness is like the great mountains. Thy judgments are a great deep. O Yahweh, thou preservest man and beast. And he preserves man. And how does he preserve man? Through the Israelites. Because the other nations are not going to receive immortality in the kingdom like we are. You know, we are a blessed people. Not every nation is going to be that, you know, on that level as we are. The heathen will still be mortal in the kingdom, meaning they'll still die. The eternals, the immortals, that deals with the nation of Israel, brothers. All right? So let's see, verse 7. How excellent is thy loving kindness, O Yahweh, the power. Therefore the children of men put their trust under the shadow of thy wings. See? So certain men are going to actually put their trust, have their faith in the shadow of Yahweh's power. You know? But there are men who don't do this. You know, obviously, the majority, the multitude is you know, not, they're not part of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, all right? They're against him. Verse 8, they shall be abundantly satisfied with fatness of thy house, and thou shalt make them drink of the river of thy pleasures. See, so there's going to be an abundance for the elect. All right? Let's get that in 2 Esdras. 2 Esdras 2:27. Be not weary, for when the day of trouble and heaviness cometh, others shall weep and be sorrowful, but thou shalt be merry and have abundance. The heathen shall envy thee, but they shall be able to do nothing against thee, saith Yahweh. Alright, so the heathen's gonna envy the elect because they're gonna see that we have an abundance and we're happy, while everybody else is losing their minds and stuff because of all the atrocities and plagues that Yahweh Bashem Yahshai is gonna allow to come down to Babylon America. Alright? So let's go back to Psalms 36 chapter. And what am I on? 9. For with thee is thy fountain of life, in thy light shall we see light. See? So in the light we see the light, meaning that's dealing with the knowledge, right? You see? Now we see the light, man. Let me get a preset real quick. Let's see. John 8:2. What else is it? Let me see. Anyway, let me go to a different preset. Let's go 1 Peter 2:9. It says, but ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, and holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should show forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. See, so that's that light. That's dealing with the Israelites, right? The royal priesthood, the chosen, right? Peculiar people, that's a strange and odd people. Just look at our people, they're strange and odd. If you look at them, let's see. Yeah, we were in darkness and called into this marvelous light, and the light is dealing with this truth, understanding it, right? The understanding of the scriptures. Let's go back to Psalms 36 and 10. It says, O, continue thy loving kindness unto them that know thee, and thy righteousness to the upright in heart. See, the ones that know Yahweh, alright? Continue loving kindness, not for everybody. No, the ones that know him. See? 2/3 of our people, like we always tell you, they don't know who Yahweh Bashem Yahshua are. Instead, they just see these, the white Jesus pops into their head, the image of an old white man with long hair, long gray hair, you know, is their image of God, of Yahweh. When Yahweh looks like the Father and the Father looks like the Son, and they're dark-skinned men with woolly hair, according to the scriptures. So that just shows you right there. It's easy, man. It's easy for us to see. That's a cut to Christianity. That's a cut to everything you see in Babylon, man. Yahweh Bashem Yahshai is a dark-skinned man with woolly hair. All right? That's how the scriptures write about him. Let me see. Verse 11. Let not the foot of pride come against me, and let not the hand of the wicked remove me. And that's what we should be praying for, you know. We don't want our pride to come between us and Yahweh, you know. You know, you don't want to be too proud where you're not willing to wear a garment and go on the corner and teach his word, or you're embarrassed to read the Bible out loud in the street, or whatever it is, you see. If you got too much pride, you know, then that's not going to be good for you. And let not the hand of the wicked remove me. Alright? So let's just, we always pray to stay in the Spirit. Pray that the Spirit stays on us. You know, pray that we stay on fire. you know. The elders were speaking on it that, hey, you know, we all should be on fire, you know. And that's why we got to examine ourselves daily to see if we're actually in this truth. You know, so, you know, dealing with, you know, are you being honest with yourself? Are you, you know, excited to do lessons? Are you excited to go to camp? You know, be on fire, you know. Verse 12. There are the workers of iniquity fallen. They are cast down and shall not be able to rise. See? So, that's going to be Esau, Edom. He's not going to be able to rise again, you know? Because he's the worker of iniquity. He's going to be cast down and he's not going to be able to rise. We get one precept to close out. Isaiah 14 and 21. Prepare slaughter for his children for the iniquity of their fathers, that they do not rise, nor possess the land, nor fill the faces of the world with cities. See? Because these Edomites are going to be exterminated according to the Bible. Alright? There shall be none left of the house of Esau, it tells you. See? But there it is right there. Prepare slaughter for his children for the iniquity of their fathers. Alright? So when you so-called white people, you Edomites, come up to the camp and you say, oh, it wasn't me that put you guys in slavery. You know, it wasn't me that, you know. So yeah, that's what it is though. You know, the iniquity of their fathers. You got to pay for what your forefathers did, according to the Bible. We had to pay for what our forefathers did. See? Prepare slaughter for the children for the iniquity of their fathers, that they do not rise. Oh, shoot. Salakia. That they do not rise, nor possess the land, nor fill the faces of the world with cities. So that's what it is. Prepare slaughter for the iniquity of their fathers. That's Esau, Edom. You know, who he's destroyed all of the tribes of Israel. And right now, we're in captivity under Esau, Edom. So he's got to pay just like we had to pay, all right? So, you know, with that, I'm going to go ahead and close out. I want to give all praise and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushai, Bahashem, HaRakakudash. Double honors goes out to the elder apostles of Great Millstone for teaching me this truth. Also, I want to acknowledge all the Akyam pushing this truth with sincerity throughout the four corners of the earth, Shalom to the elect.